Alright, this is match 2 with Dimir Aggro. This seems like a really good hand. We got a 2-drop into a 3-drop Dusk Mantle Seer, so no, I will not mulligan. Unfortunately, we're on the draw, but... Oh, Guildgate, interesting. Looks like we might be playing Maze's End. That seems a bad one, too. I want to bottom that, because I can cast everything but Dusk Mantle Seer, so... The last thing I want is another... Oh, it's quite clearly Maze's End. Look how fashionably late you are to this party, buddy. I wish I had a way to give these guys haste. That'd be... Oh, I do have a Mogus's Marauder, though. That's a thing. Necromancer... Necromancer seems good against this deck if he has, like, Supreme Verdict. I was going to say Divine Verdict, but that's not the same card at all. I'm pretty sure we just play 3-2 drops here, and then keep the pressure on. Bloop, bloop, bloop. I have a feeling he might have Warlord's Helix. That would be sad. I would cry myself to sleep. Not tonight, but I mean, there would be a night. Oh, this is Flamenco Sketches on Kind of Blue. As I mentioned previously, this is one of my favorite jazz albums ever, because it's one of the best produced, or best jazz albums of all time, I guess you would say. So, if you guys, whether you like jazz or not, you should pick up Miles Davis's Kind of Blue. Kind of Blue. You will not regret it. And it might actually make you a jazz fan. If you're afraid of that, I understand. But you should embrace it. You're gonna have to have a thing, right? Yep. Typical. Typical. That's what this is. This is just typical. Damage. Yep. This is gonna be. It's gonna be a good set of games today. I could just tell. Yeah. Gift of Orzhova. Pretty much a dead card in my hand right now. And if you guys are like, why don't you just cast it? Well, because if he does have like Supreme Verdict, I don't really want to just throw it away. So interesting. So he's actually not going to have... So he's going to take damage this turn, no matter what happens. I might want a Rapid Hybridization to this guy. That would give me a 3-3 and a 2-2. And it would deal him 1, so 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That would be 14. Mogus' Marauder would be 15, 16. He would actually go to 1. Putting a gift on that guy would do a similar thing. Is that right? Rapid Hybridization would trigger one. It would put him to 16. I would get a 3-3 and a 2-2, so this guy would trigger but replaced. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Plus, and he's at 16. And Mogus' Marauder would be another 2 this turn. So he'd actually go to 1. But how likely is it that I can never deal that 1 point? I guess with Dusk Mantle Seer, it seems pretty good. But I can Rapid Hybridization something else. Let's do that. Let's see what I can do. If I Rapid Hybridization this guy, I'm going to have the same 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, which puts him to 4. Putting this on here would put him to 2. I think I'm just going to go with the Rapid Hybridization plan, because I like actually Dusk Mantle Seer being able to just deal those last points of damage. That guy's pretty good too. And I'm actually gonna hold the Mogus here. And just play Agent of Fates. Oh, he has a fog! That's fantastic. He did have the extra CAD. Yep, Agent of Fates it is, I guess. Boop. And I'm not really worried about overextending because I have Necromancer, so he would have to actually have... My god, Maze's End. Well, guys, I apologize for two videos in a row where I can't actually, seems like my creatures are just outclassed. Alright, let's try this again! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So we have 16 on board. So... Let's see if you got the Druid's Deliverance. Of course you do. He's got 7 cards in hand. That's the other unfortunate... Yep. So he basically just draws a card and then plays a card. Draws a card, plays a card. Draws a card, plays a card. Like, he's not actually doing anything. He's just activating Maze's End, getting a Guild Gate, and then fogging. And he has 3 different fogs in the graveyard, so he has at least 12 fogs in the deck, I would presume. Man, where's the Skullcracks when you need them? Oh, they're in the other deck. Just gotta keep throwing these guys out there. Riot Control, gain infinite. Sounds good. Doesn't sound good, actually, at all. And we're gonna need second black here. Alright, well... I mean, we can always bring in Pithing Needles out of the sideboard, naming Maze's End, which is actually pretty strong because it shuts down his win condition. And we can also name Crackling Perimeter, which is another card that just shuts down the win condition. How many does he have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. He has 6 different Guild Gates right now. I wish there was like an Attack All button. Is there? There might actually be, I just don't know what it is. Yep. 5 cards in the graveyard, 5 fogs. Man, fog you, buddy. That is real immature. Am I referring to what I said? Or him fogging 5 times? Nobody knows. Rapido hybridization, though. That's not Italian, I just wanted to make it sound like it was exotic. Alright. And you can Maze's End again. Yep. 6 fogs. I basically played against 6 fogs this game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 20. I have 21 damage on board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different guilds. So, if you can play a new one this turn, you just win. How about that? Nope, just Maze's End. Okie dokie. You got one more turn. You think you have another fog in your 7 cards? Interesting. What do you target with that? Necromancer, eh? What if he does have a Supreme Verdict in hand? Wouldn't that be something? I would cry so hard. Blue, white, white. Yeah, okay. Oh boy. So you just untap and you get your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, that's really fun. It's not fun. Spoiler alert! Alright, so. Dusk Mantle's here. No, he just untaps and wins because he has two mazes in, so I don't even know why I showed him that. I guess I was like, oh, he needs two guild gates, so that's two turns, but then I remembered he does not. Okay, so Thoughtseize comes in. Gift of Orzhova comes out. Rapid Hybridization can probably come out. It seems pretty narrow here. Pithing Needles can come in. Notion Thief is kind of meh. I kind of like... Maybe Erebos is decent? I don't know. I like... not gaining life seems good, but Dusk Mantle Seer also seems good because it can deal damage through that thing. Let's take out one Agent and one Dusk Mantle Seer for two Erebos. Plus, me being able to just draw cards is pretty huge. So we're going to try it like that. I will play first. I will keep this hand. I could use another black for the Shred Freak, but... Otherwise, 2-1 drops is fine. Start with the tormented hero. Poor guy. Never gets a break. So tormented. Alright, one drops for days, it seems. Looks like we're on course to play Dusk Mantle Seer eventually, so that's nice. And bottom that thing. Is this where the fog starts? No, you definitely want to maximize your fogs. Fog is a tricky card because it's like, you don't want to use it early because if you prevent 2 damage on one turn, you're not going to be preventing 4 damage on another turn. So he's going to need a Plains in order to... I have to imagine he has like a fog right now. So I'm just going to cast this guy. The lower he is, the better Dusk Mantle Seer is, but I mean, he's obviously going to have either Druid's Deliverance or a Fog itself. Fantastic. But it seems like he doesn't have the same start as he did last game. Like, if he doesn't have a Mazes in, then we're in good shape. Get him. Yep. Big surprise! The Circus of Value! Alright, so we're gonna play this at Dusk Mantle Seer. Let's see. What's a hit here? I get a land, you get a land. Everybody gets a land. Lands for everybody. What else do I draw? Another tormented hero. So you're tapped out. You're going to block a hero probably. You take 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You take 10? That seems okay. I don't really want to commit another dude to the board, to be honest with you. Because I have a feeling there's going to be a Supreme Verdict in my future. Especially when he has a Plains. He just goes Plains, Supreme Verdict. This seems like a bad matchup for anything with a creature in it. This deck seems really good, though. Like, I don't know why it's not seeing more play. He still has 4 cards in hand. Good lord. it's really hard not to overextend into Supreme Verdict, because if you don't put enough pressure on them, you're basically just giving them the game, and if you put too much pressure on them, then you're overextending into Supreme Verdict, so. Oh, assemble the Legion as well. Fantastic. Why is this a thing? I don't understand. So you go to 7. You get a 1-1. I'm not sure I can actually beat an assemble Legion. Assemble the Legion either! Yeah, not sure I can beat an assemble the Legion. Especially when the rest of his hand is clearly, like, pump spells. There's no reason to attack with Tormented Hero, actually. Great. And not pump spells. I said pump spells, but I meant fogs. Maybe Sphinx's Revelation? If you Sphinx's Revelation, we're just skipping. We're done here. I can't beat this deck. I mean, like, he's gonna have two dudes in play. He's gonna have three blockers. That's a fog by itself, and then he's drawing three, so he goes to five cards. Yeah, no way. Oh well.